With SpaceX out of the picture, which organization is most strategically positioned to lead the future of aerospace? While companies like Blue Origin and United Launch Alliance, ULA, often come up in discussions, Rocket Lab is quickly gaining recognition as a formidable contender. But Blue Origin's consistent progress and recent successes have outpaced those of some of the industry's larger competitors, causing it to appear sluggish in contrast. As Rocket Lab prepares to launch its next-generation rocket, the Neutron, the company is poised to significantly expand its lead in the industry. How is Neutron faring, and what factors contribute to its potential as a revolutionary innovation? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio to explore the details. Rocket Lab has quickly risen to the position of the second most active private space company globally, with only SpaceX retaining its lead. Since the introduction of its Electron rocket in 2017, the company has completed more than 60 successful orbital missions, achieving an impressive record of 14 launches per year. This is a remarkable achievement for a company that has ventured into the aerospace sector following the founding of industry giants like Blue Origin and United Launch Alliance, a collaborative effort between Boeing and Lockheed Martin. Adding to the appeal of Rocket Lab's journey is the fact that the company has achieved this significant level of accomplishment without the backing of a billionaire founder. Unlike its more prominent competitors, Rocket Lab has seen its growth driven primarily by innovation, operational efficiency, and a strategic business approach, rather than relying on substantial financial backing. In the near term, Rocket Lab is focused on further enhancing the capabilities of its Electron rocket, which is known as a reliable solution for launching small payloads into orbit. However, the organization's overall vision goes far beyond just deploying small satellites. Work is currently underway to create a much larger and more powerful launch vehicle called the Neutron. This new vehicle is anticipated to have a substantial impact on the mid to long-term launch market. If successful in its goals, the Neutron has the potential to significantly change the competitive dynamics in the industry and could even challenge Blue Origin's development momentum. After spending more than two decades developing and preparing the new Glenn rocket, Jeff Bezos's company is making major strides in the aerospace industry. In contrast, Rocket Lab has set an ambitious goal of completing development of the Neutron rocket in about 5 years. This significant difference underscores Rocket Lab's dedication to fast and effective engineering practices, along with its goal of accelerating operations in a highly competitive market. Neutron's unique design sets it apart from other rockets currently in development. At 42.8 meters tall, Neutron is considered relatively small compared to other mid-range rockets. However, it makes up for this with an expanded fuselage that is projected to be 5 to 7 meters in diameter. This strong and sturdy design is specifically designed to accommodate heavy loads while maintaining a compact and efficient overall structure for the rocket. Neutron's standout and unique characteristic is its striking black facade, which stands in stark contrast to the predominantly white or metallic designs found on other rockets. This dark color was deliberately chosen as part of a design strategy that embodies both practical functionality and visual appeal. The rocket's structure is made from carbon composite materials known for their lightness, strength, and heat resistance. This makes it an ideal choice to withstand the extreme conditions encountered during atmospheric reentry. Significant advancements can be found in Neutron's focus on reusability, a core principle that is crucial to lowering the costs associated with access to space. Rocket Lab has unveiled an innovative addition to its rocket's first stage, featuring a unique integrated fairing system internally referred to as Hungry Hippo. Unlike conventional rockets that eject their fairings during flight, allowing them to descend and land in the ocean, Neutron's rocket fairing features a unique design that only partially deploys to deploy its second stage. It remains connected to the rocket and reconnects, descending back to Earth with the boosters. This method offers a number of benefits. It eliminates the need for a dedicated individual fairing recovery system, streamlines the overall design of the vehicle, and protects it from damage from exposure to salt water. Additionally, this arrangement provides increased safety for the second stage, ensuring that it remains undamaged and ready for its role on the mission. For its landing operations, Neutron will use fixed landing legs, also known as static landing legs. This leg design eliminates folding or retracting, leading to a substantial simplification of the rocket's mechanical systems. By eliminating moving components, Rocket Lab minimizes the risk of mechanical malfunctions, simplifies the manufacturing process, and speeds up the time required for repair and reuse. To improve its landing accuracy, the rocket is equipped with aerodynamic control fins positioned near the top of the booster, just below the fairing. During descent, these fins have the ability to rotate, helping to guide the booster to a safe landing. Neutron is currently still in the development and production phase. However, Rocket Lab anticipates launching the rocket soon as part of its preparations for its maiden flight. Neutron's second stage features another distinctive characteristic. Unlike conventional designs that are typically located on top of the first stage, this special component is integrated into the first stage fairing, resembling a payload. This arrangement offers greater safety during the ascent phase and facilitates a lighter design for the second stage structure. The reduced weight design improves overall flight performance and increases fuel efficiency, allowing the rocket to carry heavier payloads to greater distances in space. In short, Neutron marks Rocket Lab's bold move into the future of space exploration by combining innovative design, cutting-edge materials, and a strong focus on reusability. Rocket Lab is establishing itself as a formidable competitor in an industry traditionally dominated by larger, more financially powerful companies. If Neutron lives up to its performance expectations, it has the potential to not only compete with Blue Origin, but also revolutionize the possibilities for next-generation rockets. In an effort to enhance the functionality of Neutron's second stage, Rocket Lab has introduced an innovative satellite deployment system called Flatellite. As the name suggests, Flatellite has a sleek, flat design that facilitates efficient stacking of multiple units within the rocket's payload bay. This arrangement not only optimizes satellite deployment capacity for a single mission, but also facilitates a faster and more economical launch option for clients looking to build or upgrade their satellite constellations. However, this method involves compromises. The changes required to accommodate Flatellite reduce the likelihood of second stage reusability. While Neutron is not fully reusable at this stage of development, it nonetheless demonstrates Rocket Lab's commitment to improving the sustainability and cost-effectiveness of spaceflight in the long term. Leveraging a strategy that emphasizes partial reuse and an economical launch approach, Rocket Lab is targeting a mission price range of $50 to $55 million for its Neutron launches. This is significantly lower than many competitors in the mid-range market segment. Progress has been rapid. In early April, the second stage was manufactured and successfully passed its qualification tests, marking a significant milestone on the road to flight readiness. The heart of the Neutron propulsion mechanism is Rocket Lab's carefully engineered Archimedes engine. The engine runs on a mixture of liquid methane and liquid oxygen, often known as methalox. This contemporary and effective fuel combination is favored for its ability to produce cleaner emissions and its suitability for reusable systems. After thorough assessment, Rocket Lab has selected an oxygen-enriched closed-cycle combustion method for its Archimedes project. This setup increases efficiency by channeling excess gas into the combustion chamber, thereby increasing overall performance levels. The Archimedes engine offers impressive thrust, producing 7.8 metric tons, equivalent to 165,000 pounds, when operating at sea level. Without atmospheric pressure, as in a vacuum, its performance increases dramatically, reaching up to 90.7 metric tons, or 200,000 pounds of thrust. The system is designed to provide a specific impulse, which indicates fuel efficiency, for 329 seconds when operating at sea level and 365 seconds in a vacuum environment. The Neutron rocket will be equipped with 9 Archimedes engines, which will produce an impressive liftoff thrust of about 673.2 metric tons. While these performance metrics may seem modest when compared to larger rockets, they are in line with Rocket Lab's goal of ensuring that Neutron remains simple, efficient, and fast to manufacture. The incorporation of carbon composite materials into the rocket plays a key role in enhancing its overall simplicity. The material offers a unique combination of lightness and strength, along with impressive heat resistance and compatibility with high-speed manufacturing methods. The lab aims to automate the production of carbon composite components, which could enable the rapid manufacture of substantial rocket segments in minutes. This unprecedented production speed has the potential to revolutionize the industry in a significant way. Initial testing of the Archimedes engine, which took place in January, yielded very promising results. The engine exceeded all projections by operating at 102% of its rated power rating, highlighting the robustness of its design and the exceptional skills of the engineering team responsible for its development. To complete the Neutron system, Rocket Lab has also created a custom vertical landing mechanism for the first stage. Similar to SpaceX Falcon 9, the Neutron rocket is designed for vertical landing on Earth. This design philosophy supports reusability and facilitates a quick turnaround time between launches. For its recovery efforts, Rocket Lab plans to use a floating offshore platform that is conceptually similar to the drone ships used by SpaceX. This barge will be specifically designed to meet the structural and dynamic requirements of the Neutron landing. By landing at sea, Rocket Lab is able to improve the rocket's performance during long-distance missions while ensuring that recovery operations remain efficient. In a notable move, Rocket Lab has announced its intention to perform this landing maneuver during the maiden flight of the Neutron rocket. This is a bold initiative, especially considering the many technical hurdles that must be overcome. In previous attempts, Blue Origin attempted to achieve a drone landing with its newly developed Glenn booster during its maiden flight. But unfortunately, the attempt was unsuccessful. Nonetheless, Rocket Lab offers a competitive advantage in the industry. The company has conducted several recovery tests during landing using its smaller Electron rocket. These missions have given the company invaluable hands-on experience in booster reentry and retrieval, laying the foundation for future Neutron success. Overall, Rocket Lab Neutron initiative demonstrates a company with ambitious goals and a rapid pace of progress. Neutron showcases cutting-edge technology through its innovative flatellite system and advanced Archimedes engine. Additionally, its carbon composite structure and full reusability exemplify the blend of ambition and practicality in every aspect of its design. While surpassing SpaceX may not be a feasible goal in the near future, Rocket Lab is strategically positioned to outpace other competitors, such as Blue Origin, in terms of speed, innovation, and cost-effectiveness. What do you think about Rocket Lab and its Neutron rocket, along with Cancer Pass and Blue Origin? Do you believe they have the potential to succeed? Please share your thoughts by answering yes or no in the comments section, and feel free to explain your reasons. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on Rocket Lab, SpaceX, and the ever-evolving field of space exploration. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.